Let's talk now about the idea of measurements of variability. Here are the learning objectives, the things we want to make sure that we get out of these next series of few videos. First of all, we want to be able to compute and interpret measurements of variability for a specific data set. And we want to be able to apply and interpret two rules, the first known as the empirical rule and Chebyshev's rule. We'll discuss both of these in quite a bit of detail. First of all, here's some data that I'll be working with. You may want to pause this and enter this into TC Stats so you'll have it. This is the same data we used in some earlier videos, so you may actually already have it there. Now, why is it that we even care about the idea of measurements of variability to begin with? We've talked about the idea of measurements of location, center tendency, and it, very often knowing these measurements of location, center tendency is extremely important. And actually, those measurements of central tendency are probably the single most used measurements to compare two groups or one group against a known. They're extremely important. They're used a great deal. But often of equal importance is the idea of the measurements of variability. Now, measurements of variability tells how the data is spread out, and the idea of this spread is extremely important. And in some areas or some interests, the idea of the spread may be actually even more important than this idea of a location or central tendency. Now, the idea of the data being spread is very commonly referred to as measurements of dispersion, how the data is dispersed, how it's spread out. As a quick example here of how measurements of variability may be extremely important, if you're maybe working for like Coca-Cola or Pepsi or some type of bottling company, if you're making 12-ounce bottles of soda, you want the average to be 12. Actually, you probably want to be slightly larger than 12. And you want very, very, very small variability, because if you had large variability, that means you have overflowing product, you're making a mess out of the cans, and you're wasting product. And on the other end, you're underfilling these cans or bottles. If you're underfilling cans and bottles on a regular basis, that could lead to a class action suit. That's not a good thing. So being able to measure and describe and work with variability is actually an extremely important thing. So let's start off with the easiest, probably the easiest measurement of variability, how data is spread out, and that being the range. Now, is really is the simplest measurement of variability. And the range is really nothing more than take the largest value, subtract from it the smallest value. So you take your max and your min. Now, that data that I just showed you, in TC Stats, I use the summary statistics. I can see my minimum is 31, my maximum is 98. So my range will be 98 minus 31, which would be 67. So, how is the range useful? Well, let's just say the average for exam was 74. Actually, let's change it. Let's say it's 75. And that sounds like typically everybody did really quite okay. But if I tell you that the range was 67, what additional information does that give you? Well, if the range is actually 67, and let's just suppose I had somebody max it out and get a 100. Well, if this was actually the maximum value, if somebody really got a score that high, and I know the range is 67, well, 100 minus 67 is 33. I know somebody really had a bad day and had a score of 33. Here, my max is 98. So 98 minus 67 means that somebody got a score of a mere 31. I mean, really had a bad day. Now, the range really tells me nothing about how the data is clumped. But knowing that my mean is up here at 77, or I'm sorry, 75, and I have a maximum of 98, I know right away because of this range that however it's clumped, it's going to be something like this. I'm going to have a skewed left distribution. There's no doubt about that. And if I take this just a little bit further, and let's just do a number line, and I'm going to make this 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, You probably know already what I'm about to do. Using the five number summary, I have here a minimum of 31, so roughly in here. The maximum is 98, so roughly in here. See, Q1 was at 70, and the median was at 77, so roughly there. And Q3 is at 86, roughly there. So if I do a box plot, or box and whisker plot, you can see I was right. This is definitely a skewed left distribution. So yes, the range can be useful, but really, more typically, to measure standard deviation, or measure the variability of the data, we use the standard deviation and the variance. And that's what we're going to look at next.